Hi folks, good day to you all. I hope you all have a wonderful, wonderful day, evening, wherever you are in the world. And I'm very, very grateful and thankful that you've tuned in to my channel to have a look at my next little bit of content. And I really, really hope you enjoy it. We're on Sand River in the T-67, which is the little Tier 6 American tank destroyer. I love this little tank. It's great. It's just a fun tank to play. You know, when you get one of these tanks that just... it just does it for you. You just seem to have fun in it. This is one of them tanks. It's got naff all for armor. It's got nothing for armor. So if you get spotted and shot at, you're going to die very, very quickly. That's all I can say about that. What I would say is, if you are a budding tank destroyer player or an experienced tank destroyer player, then you'll obviously have already had the T-67. But if you're just sort of starting out and thinking, well, I don't know what line to go down, give this one a try, and I don't think you'll be too disappointed, to be quite honest. It's a patient tank. It's one of these tanks that you can't get involved in any form of brawl, because you'll lose every time. The armor on it is just non-existent. But what it does have going for it, it's got fairly decent camouflage rating, especially if you get your crew skills up, stick a camouflage net on, that kind of thing, silent driving, something like that. It really helps this tank, and you can kind of sit and assist your team from, I would say, the middle distance. You know, you don't have to be right at the back of the map or anything like that, but it's, I would say, middle distance. But what this tank is really good for is it's fast loading, and it whittles away at the enemy tanks, and it's, you know, you kind of just sort of sat there and you're just shooting away, and you just see the health of the opposing tank. It might come down 150 each time, but very, very quickly you'll get them down to a one shot. And that's what's unique about this tank, is it's really, really good. It's got fairly decent camouflage rating, and on top of all of that, it's a very fast firing cannon. Now, mobility wise, it's very, very good. It isn't too shabby at all. It certainly shifts, fairly agile, you can turn quite quickly. So there's not really a lot about this tank that there isn't to like, in all fairness. And I do like it. All right, you do get shots where you'll miss, like this thing, you know, where you're trying to hit your target and it's going left and it's going right or it's going above. That's just the way things are. That's just this game of World of Tanks that we all know and love, isn't it? And a shout out to my buddy Booty44. He's finally taken the plunge and he's come over to the dark side. Welcome, buddy. I hope you enjoy it. I really, really do. He's managed to just get his PC up and running, and he's in the throes of downloading World of Tanks PC version. So, well done, buddy. And I'm really, really looking forward to having a few games with you on the PC. And I know you're going to be absolutely blown away by it. So, fair play to you, buddy. I really, really hope you enjoy it. It's a funny old game, though, isn't it? Because... haven't played on the console for many, many years, busy from the inception of it on the console. It's weird because when you sort of transition over from the console to the PC, and I'm talking from experience here, and I still play on the console, of course, because my buddies obviously have been playing on there pretty much every day. We play together every evening. But I'm trying to convince my other buddies to get PCs as well, so they can all transition over to the dreaded dark side. But it's strange, isn't it, because how you've played. I mean, this is the longest game I've played in my life, the longest video game, you know, and I've played many video games over the years, but this is the one that just seems to have stayed. It's got longevity. I'm probably going to regret saying that, aren't I? It's got longevity. It is, let's be honest about it, it's a fabulous game, and the concept of it, especially if you're an old fart like me, and my buddies are all old farts. Well, I'm the youngest, I think I'm 21 or 22, again, and again. But the thing is, it all boils down to, it's just having fun, isn't it? It's having that release, that sort of, you know, when you've had a hard day and you just want to sit and chill out and catch up with your mates and just shoot the shit, just talk a load of crap most of the time, and that's what this is about. And it's a kind of release for people, and you can understand why some people get passionate about the game, and some are very, very good players. You look at people like Klaus Kellerman, very, very good player. Skills for you, oh, superb. That guy is just, he's on a different level. And Quickie Baby, the Mighty Jingles, all of these you know, great content creators who put videos out there. And if you don't know who I'm talking about, and I'm sure you do, and I'll be amazed if you don't, go and check them out and remember and subscribe and do the thing with them and you know, and all that kind of stuff. Because it's really important that you do that, because it takes a lot of time and a lot of effort to put, well, one, you've got to get the footage, then you've got to, you know, put it all together, video edit it, then you've got to do the voiceover, the commentary, like I'm doing now. You know, and normally it takes hours to put one video up, and you know, obviously it really helps that person out if you then go on and like or hit that subscribe button. So hint hint, nudge nudge, hit that like and subscribe, go on, do it now. And you see, the thing is, when you're a content creator, why do you do it? You know, you ask yourself the reason why do you do it, because you don't get paid for it. Well, I'd certainly don't get paid for it. I mean, I can assure you, I make absolutely zero zilch, nada, nil, diddly squat from the time that I put into putting these videos together for you. And I do it because, you know, it's nice when people hit that like button and the subscribe button, or make a comment on your video to say they enjoyed it, kind of thing. It makes it all worthwhile. It's soul destroying, I have to be honest, it's soul destroying when you've spent probably the best part of a 5-6 hours of just trying to get that video together and getting it up onto YouTube, and it hardly gets any views. And I'm talking from experience here, because all of my videos they're not the greatest for viewership or subscribership or liking and all that kind of stuff. But I do it because I enjoy doing it, and I do question myself quite a few times as to why I'm doing it, when it seems to be that, you know, there's not a lot of people watching it and liking it and subscribing and all that kind of thing. But, you know, he who dares wins rudders. You never know. One of these days, the tides might turn and I might get up one morning and find that I've had a few more subscribers or a few more people have liked it. Fingers crossed, but we'll see how it goes anyway. But I do enjoy putting these videos together for you guys. And I do hope that I do a fairly okay-ish job, that it's enough for you to either put a smile on your face or you find it interesting. If you don't, that's fine too, but either way, I do it because I do enjoy putting it out there for you, my little release, if you like. And of course, I enjoy playing the game, really enjoy playing the game. I wish I was better at it. I need to get skill to have a word with me and say, hey, this is what you're doing wrong, this is how you need to do it. Come here, I'll take you under my wing and show you how to play this game properly. But seriously, go to these content creators sites and just at least like the video if you don't want to subscribe, because it really, really helps them out, and they really do appreciate it, as I do. So I know I banged on a bit about it, but hit that bloody like and subscribe button. And the artillery, the dreaded artillery got me. But anyway, guys, we end up winning this game, and I'm going to go off to the end plates. And I really hope you enjoyed this one, and I will catch us all in the next one. But let's nip to the end plates and see how we did. So we didn't do too bad overall. We made about 20,000 profit, came top. So anyway, not too bad. A win is a win. Till the next one, guys. Have a wonderful evening, whatever you're up to. And I'll catch us all in the next one. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.